Okay, we're going to do a back up, Mr. little bridge crossing here. And again, this is a more advanced, because if a horse falls here, he's going to get hurt. So you wouldn't want to do this unless you've done this on wider bridges and you know you can control your horse's feet with a light touch. You're going to notice when Mr. T, he wants to see Buddy over there who's crying, and we're going back. And if he falls on his concrete, he'd get hurt. And if he doesn't look like he's going to pay enough attention to me, then I'm not going to do this. But in order to make sure I get him across here, I'm going to walk him on this wood back and forth, nice and slow. I want him to know what to expect. I want him to know what sound is. Right now, if you notice Mr. T, the only thing he's worried about is looking at Buddy. He's not paying attention to me very much. So that's a hindrance, and I need to be aware of that when I'm working him. So we're going to walk on this little wood here, and I'm going to try to keep him on Mr. T's feet. And I'm going to have to get my hand a little bit closer to his head here, because I want to be able to control his head, because he's not really looking. So see his feet? Look, see, he's not paying attention. That's telling me right there he's not paying attention. He's not looking on the ground. He'll step off. So I'm going to back him up and say, no, I don't want you there. See those feet there? See how they're to the left? I don't want that. So that's telling me he's not ready to cross. If I get him across here, he's going to slip and fall. He'll kill himself. So I'm going to back him up. And I want to see if I can get his feet where I want them. See, now I got his body sideways. See, he's still walking to that left there because he's not paying attention to me, and he's going to get his butt killed if I take him across here because he's paying attention to Buddy. He's not listening to me. He's in a hurry. He's not looking down. If he was looking down, he wouldn't be on that edge right there. But if he's not looking there, when he goes forward, he's going to lose his back foot. So we're going to back up. Back up. See, he's going off that edge. Back up. See, that's telling me he's not doing it. So I'm going to bring him more at an angle this way, since he wants to favor that right side there. Easy. And he still wants to go. See that? See that? I really got to have his head there. See? See how he's walking right there? See that back feet there? I've got to be able to... See, normally he would be scared. He's not really scared of the bridge. He's too damn worried about paying attention to his herd, and he's not listening to me. He's not looking at me. He's not paying attention to me. That's where people mess up. They try to do something and they don't realize they don't have their horse. Mr. T can fall right now if I let him go very hard, and he'd probably bang himself up. I mean, he may break a leg and I'd have to put him down. So when we put horses in situations where they can get hurt, it's your responsibility. I don't like the way he's hanging to the left. He's hanging to the left, to my left, because he's looking to his left at Buddy. So he's not paying attention. So I'm going to back him up. Watch, his foot may slip there. Back. I'm really watching his feet. Look at that. Look at that. Danger. Danger. See, he's not paying attention to me. And he's not paying attention to a lot of reasons. One is I got this damn camera out and I'm messing with him. Two is he's just too damn worried about paying attention to Buddy. He is totally ignoring me. Look at that head. Back up. I'm going to put some pressure on. Back up. You better pay attention. You're about to fall down a stinking hill. Knock it off. Now I got his attention. See, no, I don't. Look where he's looking. See, he's got that draw of that barn and Buddy, and he is not paying attention to me. That's why this is so dangerous. So I have to decide whether or not I'm going to do this. Now, I could take him through the dirt, and that would be easy. But I've taken him over smaller things in this, and I like him to be able to walk where I tell him in case I come to a wood or something and I have to cross and it's small. I would rather this wasn't quite as high as this. But we've done low ones. Oh, now you want to come in and be my buddy. Poor Mr. T. Dad was mean to him. I know. He's so abused. Got to pay attention. I'm putting this horse in a risky situation, and I have to know that he's going to pay attention to me, which he is now because I put some pressure on him, that when we come across here, you got to follow your head. I've got to be able to control you with a light touch. I cannot get in a fight with you in the middle of here. So now if I walk on this side, there, now he's walking on the side. But when I get in front of him, I kind of block his view. Good boy. Easy. 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 See, I'm worried about those back feet back there. And this camera makes it more dangerous because I'm not focusing on him. Easy. So we're going one step at a time, very slow. I'm looking at all 4 feet, making sure they're in the right area. Easy. That back foot's about to fall off. Yeah, you are. I know! Now, see, that back foot almost went off, and I wanted to be clear so he could jump. And when I kind of moved out of his way, he was like, uh-oh, what happened? I got to jump. So my action scared him. Now, I walked him across here before I got on this video because I didn't want to have the video in the hand to make sure he could do it. But we only went across this one time, and I thought I could go ahead and control him. It was dangerous. I put him in jeopardy. I put him in harm's way. If he got hurt, it would have been totally my fault. Because I'm talking on a camera, I've changed the situation. I've got Buddy over there. He was nervous. It was a new area. It was high. The sun's out. The sun's right in his eyes. So that's kind of creating a glare. There's all kind of factors that if I look at his head, he wasn't being a stupid spooky horror. We've walked across, maybe not thinner, maybe a little thinner than this, but it was metal. It wasn't wood. Sometimes it had a rail and sometimes it didn't. But I want my horse to be able to follow me wherever I want. Now, I've seen people come out here and try to make their horse walk over this from on the saddle. And they'll get in a fight, back and forth, correct the horse, make the bit, spur him, you better listen. Do all this crap while they're on the horse's back. I would never take my horse across something like this on his back until I made him comfortable that he could follow me on the ground where I had a little bit more control. I had a little bit more ability to work and control him. Hi, Mr. D. I know, it's scary. I know, it's scary. You're a good boy. Now, I could do this a few more times, and he would get good at it, and it would be no big deal. Then I'd get on his back, and I'd do it. I just wanted to, again, these bridges and things like this, when you expose your horse to trailers, to barns, to stalls, to tight areas, there was an incident. A lady let someone else take her horse out, and she took her through an alley that she had never used. The horse freaked out, reared up, hit his head on a ceiling, fell on his back legs, hurt its back legs. Buddy and all of them got jacked up, so Mr. T's totally not paying attention to me. If horses were running and doing all this crap when I was trying to film this or trying to get him over, I would have had to realize that and stop. And what most people would do is they would get mad at the horse. Stupid horse, he's not listening to me. You better pay attention to me. Fine, I'll just make you fall off. You'll learn your lesson. All that macho crap instead of saying, hey, you know what? I've got to be sure that I've got my horse's attention. I've got to be sure that he knows what's up. I know he's a good boy. I know. Oh, my goodness, you should never let a horse lick you because he'll bite you and he'll eat you. Poor Mr. T, you want a little salt. I know he's a good old boy. So anyway, Buddy's going to come out here now. He's really going to mess up the program. I'm not going to do this again. I just saw it. I figured I'd make a quick video on it. Hopefully you understand you saw the importance of being able to control your horse lightly, to have your horse's undivided attention when you're doing something that's dangerous, that puts them in harm's way. All right, Mr. T, you're a good old boy as usual. Buddy, you're coming out here to cause problems. I guess we'll end that there. Buddy! He didn't answer me, little shit. We'll end that there.